Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info.
2016 was another exciting year in space discovery. Like every other year in recent memory, major surprises dominated science headlines. From the detection of X-rays from Pluto, to the possible falsification of the hypothesis of dark matter. However, science media also declared some victories for the standard cosmology, most notably the purported detection of gravitational waves. In this episode, the Thunderbolts Project's chief science advisor, physicist Wal Thornhill, offers a perspective on the current state of science and the electric universe as we enter 2017.
On every New Year's Day, I wonder whether this will be the year the Thunderbolts Project and the electric universe gain significant mainstream media attention. I think 2017 offers the best opportunity yet. There are two reasons for saying this. The first relates to our Sapphire project, and the second to human nature. Let's take the Sapphire project first. Sapphire is an electrical experiment, far more sophisticated than the one that Christian Birkeland carried out over a century ago, in which he subjected a magnetized globe suspended in a vacuum chamber to electric discharges. He called it his Torilla, or Little Earth. Birkeland discovered the foundations of the electric universe, but mathematical theorists who had no use for such a complicating factor as electricity ignored him. Birkeland's story by Lucy Jago, The Northern Lights, is well worth reading. So today you'll find no mention of electricity in any textbook on astronomy or astrophysics. It is a failing that ensures the 20th and early 21st century will be remembered only for its odd beliefs. If Sapphire is successful, and all indications so far point that way, we will, for the first time in history, understand how the Sun really works. And since the Sun is our touchstone for understanding all other stars, such an understanding must revolutionize cosmology. Stars are not isolated nuclear campfires in the sky. Scientists a century ago, effectively in the horse and buggy era, grasped upon the recently discovered nuclear energy to explain how a star might keep shining for the eons required by the misguided gradualist theories of geologists. Sir Arthur Eddington invented a simplistic, gravitating ball of gas model of the Sun. But the Sun is an almost perfect sphere, which is impossible if gravity shapes its rotating body. Particle physicists joined in the game and invented a complex and unverifiable sequence of nuclear reactions, requiring that the center of the Sun be composed of the lightest gas, hydrogen. This profoundly unlikely condition has remained unquestioned despite the fact that almost every observable feature of the Sun denies Eddington's model. And there is no feedback mechanism known that could control hydrogen fusion to within 0.1%, which is how steadily the Sun shines. The hydrogen bomb model of star should have the night sky look like the 4th of July. So what if we don't understand the Sun? Well, it changes everything. It means scientists are wasting billions of dollars trying to generate energy like the Sun. It means the trillions of dollars spent on the Large Hadron Collider, on fusion research, on gravity waves, on astronomy and space research, is largely wasted. The questions being asked are the wrong ones, and the data is being misinterpreted. The modern mysteries to be solved are not real, they are artifacts of the models. The computer models are incorrect. Big science today is a train wreck in slow motion. Big Bang cosmology is our atlas of the universe, depicting our place within it. But our cosmic atlas is little advanced beyond a medieval map. Instead of being centered on the Mediterranean, it has a geocentric perspective. Experiments on Earth become consecrated as universal laws and universal constants. The universal law of gravity, for example, has unexplored regions populated by monstrous black holes which swallow all that comes near. It has an edge beyond which one cannot go. That edge follows logically from a mythical beginning called the Big Bang. But the concept of an edge requires there to be an outside which defies the meaning of universe, which is everything that exists. Trouble is, The Big Bang is only required by the universal law of gravity to primordially blow everything apart. Why that initial state didn't constitute a black hole is not explained. The Big Bang universe is unstable because of the tendency for everything to fall back in again. I use the words law of gravity because that law is merely an equation, while gravity itself is not understood. The necessity to introduce imaginary dark matter and dark energy to save appearances is evidence of this. Mathematicians need to assume that the law is universal and that gravity always behaves as we experience it here on Earth. Otherwise, they're out of business. Clearly, this is a belief driven by necessity. It's not science. So it's no surprise that the Big Bang creation myth was born as a kind of restatement of the creation story of Western cultures by Georges Lemaître, a Belgian Roman Catholic priest and astronomer. It seems we need a cosmology that addresses our existential fears and makes us feel safe. But safe from what? That is the question never asked by scientists today. As the Australian philosopher David Stove wrote in his book Anything Goes, Newtonian physics is a guarantee against the occurrence of just about anything disagreeable. This brings me to human nature. The last revolution in science occurred in the time of the upheaval and chaos of the First World War. You may notice I didn't say scientific revolution, since there was very little about it that was scientific. The Copenhagen interpretation of quantum theory is probabilistic. It disconnects cause and effect, disregarding a fundamental principle of physics. And Einstein's relativity removes the absolute frame of reference essential for measurement in physics. For example, if two clocks are moving relative to one another with velocity v, there is no way of special relativity theory telling which clock is ticking slower than the other, because all you have is a single piece of information, v, that is symmetrical for the two clocks. So much for the twin paradox. It ain't physics. So it's no surprise that these two theories that are supposed to be the pillars of modern cosmology, one at the subatomic level and the other at the cosmological scale, are incompatible. It's astonishing that science can be as impervious to self-correction in this modern era as it was when the Earth was thought the centre of the universe. Newton was right. Celestial bodies know each other's positions instantly, in defiance of Einstein's speed of light prohibition. Quantum spooky action at a distance and entanglement show a similar instantaneous resonant connection between separated matter. There is a universal time. What physical clocks do depends on where they are and how they are moving with respect to other bodies in the universe. But it seems we need another revolution before scientists will give up their computerized virtual reality and return to physics.
For continuous updates on space news from the Electric Universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.